Here are the rules. There are three rounds, mandatory mystery ingredients for each course. If your dish doesn't cut it, you will be chopped. And you are here for our viewers' choice competition. All of the ingredients were selected via social media by our fans.
Awesome. No. No way. Nervous.
I'm expecting eyeballs or heads or something like that. It's gonna be crazy.
Please open your baskets. And Facebook users chose for your appetizers, rum raisin ice cream, broccoli spigarello, potato tots, and potted meat.
Potted meat is like a cat food.
20 minutes on the clock, chefs. Starting now.
Really, viewers, why are you doing this to me? This basket is like getting a kidney stone removed.
I'm not sure about that meat in a can. It's actually pork based with tripe. You know we have to eat four plates of this.
This isn't relabeled cat food, is it? Being curious.
I'm very familiar with potted meat. That was the type of food I was eating growing up. We were very poor. We never had farm to table fresh food. It was always out of boxes and cans. I'm making a potted meat pate and potato crostini. I'm just like, hey, yo, I can do this.
Growing up in Montana, we grew up farm to table. We usually had like a dozen garden beds and a greenhouse and raspberry patch. There's very, very little processed food in our house. But I love potato tots because I know that I can manipulate this ingredient into something great. So I'm making a potato croquette with potted meat. I love fresh flavor. So I add lemon zest, thyme, rosemary.
I'm making a puree of potato tots with the chipotle pate sauce. I put some milk and cream and the potted meat, and I put a little bit of chipotle inside to give a kickness. I'm proud to be in America. I love the American way of life and the American cooking, but I learned cooking from the French culinary training program. It's like going to the army in America because it's very sharp, it's very organized, and you need to be a winner. That's why I can wing chopped.
Potted meat, rum raisin. Overall, I think the viewers wanted to be as evil as possible with this mystery basket. Potted meat, really? Anything that you can only smear is kind of creepy. I want to make the mousse of the potted meat. I really need to mellow it out.
We're not aligned.
I'm gonna add some pistachios, ricotta, heavy cream, and orange zest. My sister passed away when I was 21 years old and really left my mother in a bad place. That's what drove me even harder to only pursue positive situations and accomplish my goals. And that brought my mother back to life. I just want to come in and win for her.
And chefs, 15 minutes left to go.
Keep calm, keep calm.
The broccoli spigarello, it's the leaves of the broccoli plant.
At least it's a fresh ingredient, and I'm happy about it.
Absolutely.
It's gonna definitely pick up.
Broccoli spigarello, I just sear the crap out of it. Potato tots, yes, I love you. We have a very deep, passionate relationship. Just get them fried and mix it into the spigarello. I want to win that $10,000 so I can finally take my son on vacation. I don't get to spend a lot of time with him. This industry is so demanding. You're putting in 70 to 80 hours. It's exhausting, but he's already proud of me, and I'm already his hero, he told me.
I know that I want a sauce for my croquette. I add some of the rum raisin ice cream to the spigarello, puree it down. And then I'm adding the spigarello inside the croquette, and it'll be a really nice textural note.
Broccoli spigarello is definitely bitter, like a dandelion green. I'm adding apple to add acidity and sweetness. Then, boom, I cut myself on a peeler.
We gotta cut, Erica cut herself.
I'm not an amateur, and it felt like an amateur move.
Just need a band-aid, please.
Waiting for the medic is excruciating. It feels like forever.
And chefs, 5 minutes remaining.
The clock is always my enemy. I'm scared to get chopped. I really don't want to go home. Cutting myself shook me up a little bit, but I get a new red apple and a new peeler. I'm gonna add some apple and onion with the broccoli spigarello. Now I'm thinking I've gotta have some sort of crostini. It's gotta be crisp. I'm not going to be able to toast these in the oven in 5 minutes. So I'm going to the fryer with them.
Sesame seed oil, rice, wine.
I really love to eat a croquette that's been fried, like with a nice little acidic salad. I grab some arugula, I grab a little sherry vinegar, some olive oil, and just get it dressed up for the plate. Viewers, bring it on.
How many times do we get stopped and people says, who puts all the stuff in the basket?
Now they do.
Now they do it, right? So
why are the fans so mean to you? What did these judges ever do to you?
Oh, that rum raisin ice cream, that is a tricky ingredient. How do you transform something so sweet? I add it into that salty potted meat, put that on a crostini.
All right, chefs, 2 minutes.
All right, start plating, guys.
All over it.
I don't have plates. I like to push myself to the maximum of my limits. I add those broccoli spigarolo to the potato tots. I know I want to create like a kind of polenta. That's why I'm adding the parmigiano and the chicken broth.
The rum raisin ice cream is a good wild card. I'm incorporating a little bit of the orange into that. Add a little black pepper to add some savory notes. I haven't even really tackled the tater tots yet, so I've just got to get the tater tots on there somehow.
Hi. Come on, guys. A minute.
1 minute,
go.
Chef.
Wait. Jeremy, put something on the plate, babe.
I'm smearing on my pate. Plate.
And chefs, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time's up. Please step back.
Yeah.
That was so compulsive.
That was a hot mess.
Yeah. Viewers, I'm doomed.
Did you do it?
Did it.
Ah, nice.
Ah. Lovely. We made it through the appetizer round. Viewers, I can't wait to see what you have in store for the entree round.
I think that's the easy round.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think that's the easy one.
Chefs, you have arrived at the chopping block. In the appetizer round, our friendly fans wanted to see you cook with potted meat, rum raisin ice cream, broccoli spigarello, and potato tots. Chef Aaron.
Today for the appetizer course, I've prepared for you a potato croquette with potted meat and broccoli spigarello with a puree of rum raisin ice cream and broccoli spigarello.
By the way, that was a really fun round to watch. It's really fun to watch such pros go at it.
Thank you for the challenge. For me, high energy and adrenaline, like I thrive on that. I was in a band for 10 years, performing live all over the country, and our lead singer used to vomit before shows. I was the one like jumping around like a boxer, getting ready to like go. So to do this, it's so much fun.
Awesome.
Well, I'm happy that you went the croquette route. I really love the texture. It has a beautiful crunch. And I love the addition of the spigarello inside of it.
This croquette is great. It's light, it's airy, it's flavorful. That canned meat, you put just the right amount in there.
The only real miss here is this sauce. It's just very sweet.
Yeah.
Very, very sweet.
I think if you put a little heat in this sauce, it would have really been a home run.
Awesome.
Thank you, Chef Aaron. Next up, Chef Erica.
I created a mousse of the potted meat with pistachio and deep fried crostini with a rum raisin sauce.
Very clever to make a mousse. And the ricotta was, I think, the right call. A really good idea to serve sort of a little crouton with that. Smart. But I'm a little disappointed in the potato tot. It seems that you just sort of warmed it up and moved it over here.
I wish you would have taken that potato, cooked it, and then put it into that puree, because I think it would have gave it body.
The viewers got you right here on this sauce. This is really way too sweet. It's going to kill anything else on the plate.
Thinking back, I would have probably gone for some red chili flake, a little more acidity. Use the vinegar in there.
Chef Erica, thank you.
Thank you.
Next up, Chef Jeremy.
Sure, I made a pot of meat and potato crostini with charred sprigarello.
So how do you feel about this thematic viewer's choice and all the curveballs being thrown at you?
I'm ready for anything, bring it on. Growing up in Georgia, I was raised on food stamps. So canned goods, those boxed ingredients, you know, I'm well familiar with, and I'm familiar with the pot of meat too.
The potted meat is good. You really did a great job with taming the meat and taming the ice cream.
And the spigarello, I think, is dynamite. It's charred, it has a really hard sear on it.
But the execution is kind of sloppy.
Thank you, Chef Jeremy. And finally, Chef Matthias.
So I made for you like a puree of potato tots with spigarello broccoli, a puree of rum ice cream. And I make a potted meat sauce with a little bit of spicy inside.
What you've done with the potted meat is great. You brought enough heat in there.
You really took the potato tots and really transformed them. I think it's a really smart thing to puree them and make like a polenta out of them with cheese.
And I love the big leaves of the spigarello, but I don't like this rum ice cream. It's too sweet. That xanthan gum thickener, I think, only illuminated more of the sweet properties of that ice cream.
It must be quite strange for you to allow yourself to have no control over the ingredients.
I love challenges. You need to challenge yourself when you're a chef. And I just purchased a house in Miami. So I need $10,000 to put in my new kitchen. I need a fridge. I need to build some cabinets. I need those $10,000.
All right, Chef Matthias, thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right, chefs, please take a few minutes and the judges will make up their minds. Thank you.
That was a tough basket. I mean,
I don't think that was as hard as a viewer's choice basket that maybe I would have dreamt up. Fish heads, pig's tails, or some really tough cut of meat.
But that damn rum raisin.
Yeah, it got the best out of all of us.
There's no way in hell I'm ready to go home right now. No way. Worked too hard.
The viewer's choice was a curveball, but I want to win to show my son, Jadam, that his father can do anything.
Only three can move on to the entree round. So, whose dish is on the chopping block?